Jimmy Star Show with Ron Russell, bringing you the good times in music, fashion, pop culture, and entertainment. We have a great show for you guys today. Before we get started, let me introduce my cool, outrageous man about town co-host, Mr. Ron Russell.
Oh, we're on the air. We're on the air again. Oh my God, this never ends. The show just keeps every week. Another show. I'm going to kill myself one day right on the show. Hi, everybody.
There you go. We got the man behind the boards, Mr. Chad Murphy.
Oh, there.
He's doing the same thing.
Same thing.
Oops, same thing.
There you go.
Boring.
Let me hit my mute button. Boring. Hello, fellas. How you doing?
We're doing fine. We're seated on our new beautiful white sofa.
There's too much glare. Too much glare on the pictures.
I know.
Yeah, I know. We have to get glass that has no glare glass. But I want to talk about the pictures. Uh-huh. I have my dearest in the world friends on this wall, not just people who signed autographed photos for us. I don't go for that jazz. But behind me is the wonderful Jane Russell.
Yeah. I thought that was you for a second.
That's my headshot. That's me in drag as Jane.
Oh, that is you. Okay.
Color. And then there's Blackwell, Mr. Blackwell, who is my sweetest, dearest, most loving friend in the world, my dearest friend. And Betty Davis, who I knew really quite well. She was a fun lady. And Jane and I again. You know, that's it. The rest of the people we know are just acquaintances. But these were friends of mine.
That's not true.
Well, we spoke on a daily basis, you know, and we hung out. We went out together. And we shared secrets. You know, that's what friends do.
Ron,
secrets I ever tell.
That's a nice actually, wall of fame.
Yeah, that's right. I have Brooke McCarter, though, on my side, who was a great friend of mine. We probably hung out, I don't know, once a month for 5 years. He was the star of The Lost Boys, one of the lost stars of The Lost Boys. And Carmen Electra, she's not a great friend of mine, but I have been to 5 or 6 parties, and I did walk the red carpet with her at the MTV Awards. And Malcolm McDowell, who I've been to dinner with several times, dinner and lunch. So Elton John's the only one that I've only worked with once. But hey, once is better than never. So what are you going to do? Nice. We got a chat room full of people, you guys. So we want to like say hi to everybody in the chat room. It looks like Dave from Stars Now UK is here.
Dave.
Patricia Grant. What did you say, Chad?
I said Dave.
There you go, Dave.
Jimmy, pick up your mic because when you lean forward, you look weird.
Eileen Shapiro is in the chat room.
Eileen, I thought you were at the dentist's office getting your adjustments.
What?
Getting your adjustments.
Her dentist is really good with a drill, and he drills the bra straps on her bra and puts in other, you know, hooks. Of course, she has to really have some special equipment to hold up her boobs.
Oh.
They put metal rods in her bra straps to hold those babies up. You know, she keeps toppling over. I feel bad for the poor thing. She gets up in the morning and she falls on her face. They're so heavy.
Sounds painful.
Well, they have to hang weights in the back. So if you don't look at Eileen, you know, when you're looking at her forward, she looks normal. If you see her from the back, you'll see from those bra straps are 30-pound weights on each strap. That's what gives her balance, buoyancy.
Illy from Estonia is in the chat room. And I want to like give a special shout out to Patricia Grant. Pat, she's at Cody Fans on Twitter, and she's also got a brand new account. It's at Jimmy_Ron_Fans.
Cool.
It's a Twitter account for fans of the Jimmy Star Show with Ron Russell that Pat's running, and we want to thank her for setting it up. She's been promoting all kinds of stuff in all our past shows. And
I
all
hate
kinds
the
of
word
stuff.
Fans. I'd rather we say friends. I want you all to be my friends, not my fans. Fans,
yeah, they're both.
That's good.
Well, fans is like a word from the 1940s, and it had a different meaning. Today, fans means like, you know, I don't know what it means.
No, Ron's
friends,
got a point.
Friends is nice.
You got a good point.
I have 2,000-something friends that like my work, and that's fine with me.
More than 2,000.
More than 2,000. Who the hell knows?
He's not good with numbers, you guys.
No, yeah. The numbers keep going up and up and up and up and up.
Somebody says the second to last picture of you is outstanding, which I don't know what that one is.
The second? That's
the one of you in drag.
As Jane, that's me in drag as Jane Russell years ago, which is starting to become a big thing among my friends or fans, if you wish. I said to them, listen, I'm old. You know, a man gets old just like a woman gets old. It's no difference. So if a man transforms into a woman and he's 77, he's going to look like a 77-year-old bitch trying to look 20. And what's more revolting than an old lady trying to look 20? An old lady at 77 should look gorgeous at 77, sort of like Sophia Loren looks or Laura Bacall did, my sweet Lauren. So many of the stars of yesteryear. So I said that I would go and drag again, just my face probably. I don't want to go to the clothes bit. And see what I look like as a 77-year-old Jane Russell. Now, Jane died at 89, and she was exquisite, which is in this picture here to my left. That picture of her in the turquoise top, she's 85 years old there. And she looked wonderful. So I thought I would portray Jane at 77. And my show is called All About Jane. It starts off with me talking about her life, where she's from, who she belongs to, where she was raised, what her religious feelings were, what her mother taught her, all the movie stars she encountered, Howard Hughes putting her in that movie where he exposed some cleavage and made her a superstar, that everybody was fainting over her bust, which was only a 36B and nothing bigger. And back in those days, I guess, exposing a 36B was a big deal. Today, you have to have those fake things, you know, 99Zs. Now, Eileen Shapiro's got the real thing. Everybody, her 44DDD XYZs are real. So we should put her in a movie. If Howard Hughes met her, he would have. But anyway, we're going to do this show, and I want to do it for charity. I want to raise money again for the causes that I believe in, and one of them is...
Oh, shit.
What you're doing, Jimmy?
Well, I'm trying to get this...
Well, you're overrunning what I'm saying.
I'm not doing it on purpose.
No, I know that, but stop it.
He's bringing up a monitor for you. Take it easy.
He's got to touch every damn thing he's got like that. You know that disease that children have, where children have to touch everything? They come in a room and they must walk around and touch everything.
Curious.
What is it called?
Curious.
No, not curious. It's called stupid.
No, I'm trying to fix the chat room so I can see. I can't see what's going on.
Well, meanwhile, anyway, getting back to what I'm doing, I want to do it for charity, and I'm going to start doing it to raise money for the Desert AIDS Foundation here in Palm Springs. The Desert AIDS, what is it called? There's a whole name, whatever. I'll get it right next week. They do so much for people that have AIDS. They give them food. They give them money for their drugs. They take care of them. They help them morally and mentally to be happy and alert, not to think of they're going to die, because not too many die anymore from AIDS. We have the cocktail, which prevents it and stops you from, you know, going forward with the disease. So I would like to do that again, because I'm the founder of Have a Heart, and I founded it years ago in New York City, and I gave it away when I no longer could do it. And Have a Heart today belongs to somebody new. But I raised hundreds of thousands of dollars with my drag show, other drag shows. Then I worked for the Elizabeth Taylor Foundation for AIDS Research here in California, and we gave them a ton of money. Since AIDS is still around and it's still killing millions of children and people, not just gay people, but people, I feel that I'd like to go back to work and raise some more money and give it to AIDS. And if I have any money left over, I want to give it to our local dog pound so they have enough money to feed all the puppies and doggies that nobody wants and they got rid of. And they're in the pound now, which they don't kill them. They, you know, put them up for adoption. So I figured those two good causes, you know, Jane would like it. She's up in heaven, and she would look down and say, Ron, yes, use my body, impersonate me. Say whatever you like, because I trust you, and I know you won't harm me, which I never would, because I love and adore Jane Russell. I miss her every day. And my buddy, Mr. Blackwell, remember him? He wrote the 10 worst dress list. Anyway, Richard and I were dear friends, and they're all gone because they're old. Okay. So that's it. That's my long speech of the morning.
All right, everybody. So listen up. First, we want to say hi to so many people in the chat room. Illy from Estonia.
We have Dave from Stars Now UK. Hannah Clive is in the chat room from the UK. Patrick Talbot is in the chat room. He's Ghostly Beard on Twitter. Pat, don't change the fan thing. Keep it fans. I think that sounds cooler. And
you know, Jimmy,
and it's a lot of fun.
Ego. I'm sort of modest about certain things.
Okay, but
I never had fans.
But their friends follow you on Twitter, and your fans are following a fan account.
When I was very famous in New York many years ago, 40 years ago, I was very famous as an entertainer, nightclub entertainer, stand-up comic as Jane Russell. I had a fan club, and I told them to change it to Ron's Friend Club.
Okay,
anyway,
but we've
fans
already
is,
got
fans
that.
Fans is okay. Whatever you want to call fans are fine.
And Pat, we want to thank you for doing that because you didn't have to do that. It's so cool. We got a couple of hundred followers
thank
already.
Thank you.
Goddess is in the chat room.
My dearest one, where are you? What's going on? I know nothing about you. You put crazy shit on Facebook. You write these beautiful things, and I don't know if you're going through a bad time, a broken heart. I mean, what's going on with the engagement that you're engaged for 37 years? Are we marrying this guy? Did we get rid of this guy? What's the deal? People want to know. Are you single? Are you looking? Answer all my questions, my mon petit pousse.
Also, she said friends is too long. It doesn't fit because they only give you 15. Good, Pat. That makes me even happier.
Okay, so fans, so all of you out there, I'm not egotistic like this one next to me.
Also, hang on. No, B Claudia from Germany's in the chat room. What's up, B?
Always lovely, always wonderful, always kind and sweet and dear. And writes the most delicious things on Facebook. And, I mean, I love her. I would love to meet you one day and give you a big hug.
Somebody said you have to accept them on Facebook, but I'm not sure who it is. Chad, they're having trouble logging in with Facebook. Like, is there something wrong with the chat room app?
Who wants
I have no clue about that.
Say that again, Chad?
I have no clue about that.
Okay, I don't know, you guys. Sorry why you can't log in via the Facebook app. Everybody's saying they can't log in through it, so I don't know who that is who said that you haven't accepted them on Facebook, but I'll look at your request.
Well, listen,
I'll be able to figure it out.
I just put about 40 people on the other day. I went through my list, and I added 40 new people to my Facebook page. If I oversighted you, which I doubt, or if you're having trouble, please message me, instant message me, and I will immediately friend you as a friend.
There you go.
I appreciate
I think that's Goddess who said she's good and she's in a good place always, and somebody else says thank you, Ron, but I don't know who it is since I don't know. They just say user chat, user Vegu, user this, user that.
But Goddess, you didn't answer my question. Are you still with the guy, the same guy for like 100 years? Answer me,
I think
honey.
That's Goddess that says I love you too, Ron, but I'm not sure.
I love Goddess, but she's not loving me lately. She doesn't write me. She just ignores me. I don't think she's going through something.
I can always tell when B writes something because B like has a way of writing. She writes, thank you so very much, Ron and Jimmy, and I know that that's B. Even though it doesn't say B, that's B.
There are just some people on this planet that are exceptionally wonderful with kind hearts, and they don't mind saying what they feel.
Oh, that's Hannah Clive, who says that you have to add her on Facebook.
Hannah, what's the problem? You're probably there already, a dizzy queen.
She wouldn't be saying that.
Hannah, you're probably there as a friend already. I know you for thousands of years.
I'll check Hannah.
I will check Hannah and instantly put you in. I'm sorry about that. How the hell could that have happened? You sure you didn't get kicked out?
Yeah, right.
Well, I don't know. Facebook does what the fuck it wants, you know. Excuse me, it makes me curse. Yeah, that's I hate Facebook. It causes me to say dirty words. But Facebook is just turning around and becoming like Hitler. It does what it wants. I write things. It doesn't publish it because they don't like if I say bad about them, the poor things.
Oh, well. So what's up? So, Chad, does it look like our first guest is online?
Hold on. Let me take a peek right here.
Okay. We don't have our
– Yeah, I think everybody's online.
Jim and I are debating whether we should have a boom or – lavaliers, and that's the reason why we're holding the mics.
Also because they're super expensive.
I'd probably try the clip-ons first.
But they're a lot of money, Chad. Like $130 a person. That's like $260 plus tax.
What you're holding in your hand's probably about $110, isn't it?
Yeah, probably.
I know. These pieces
are just had them for such a long
time.
Sound
good.
Mine is my mic that I used to use 100 years ago in my show.
No, these are new.
They're not mine?
These are the new ones, yeah.
Where's my mic? My mic was good. I paid about $60 for it 100 years ago. That was a lot of money. That's probably a $500 mic today.
Start selling them orange cups and you can buy a couple lavalier mics.
I know, we're working on it. We've been looking. We've actually been looking.
Orange cups. Well, you know, I can't find them and I really hate to sell them. I mean, that's kind of cheesy.
What? It's you great.
Know. Yeah, I know, but I'd rather if somebody sent me $1 million that's watching our show and we could finish the studio with
it. So here's what we're going to do, Chad. We're going to call our first guest. While we're calling him, let's play a song.
All right.
How about we'll play Narrow Planes I Should Have Known? You have that one?
Yep. Who did? Sure who sang
all
that?
All right, everybody.
Wait,
so,
wait, ho, ho,
ho, ho, ho, ho.
What?
Narrow Planes by who?
Narrow Planes is the name of the band. The name of the song is I Should Have Known, and it's a song we're going to play while calling our first guest, Will Crewdson.
Oh, I never heard this song. It's a new one.
All right, everybody, check it out. Here's Narrow Planes, I Should Have Known. And when we come back, we'll be with our guest, Will Crewdson. See you in a sec.
Uh-oh. Hello. Take two.
All my thoughts are leading somewhere no one knows. In my ears feeding all these doubts they show. And if you tell me all you think I should be, yeah, I already know. Oh, no, no. The only place they know, someone they believed in, told them all to go. And if you tell me where you think I should be, yeah, I already know. So tell me, I should know, I should know. The lights were on, but clearly no one's home. I should know. Oh, no, no. Just tell me, baby, how I could have known. All my time you wasted. If they just wanna use me, then they'll let me go. And if you tell me how you think it should be, you're out and know. So tell me, I should know, I should know. The lights were on, but clearly no one's home. Should know. Oh, no, no. Just tell me, baby, how I could have known. Head down if you feel fine. If there's fortune that leads your your time, but I heard it wasn't mine. Now tell me, I should know. Oh, no, no. They load the dice before you even throw. I should know. Oh, no, no. Tell me, baby, how I could have known.
All right, there you go, Jimbo.
Hey, what happened to our band? Everybody, that's Narrow Planes, by the way. I Should Have Known is the name of the song, and our guest wasn't there, though, Chad.
Yeah.
Well, wait a second. If that song doesn't get you up and wild and crazy, you're dead.
The chat room loved it. Which, by the way,
I love that
I think
song.
We got Dustin now. Dustin, you there?
I'm here. Hey.
That's you turn on, toggle Will, on your video,
up,
please?
Shut up for a minute, Will. We're talking about your song.
That's not Will's song, so don't just...
Oh, what a shame, Will. That's a great song. Too bad it's not yours.
Hey, Will. Hey, Will. Wait a second.
Calm down.
I love being old.
Dustin.
It's so fucked up.
Wait a second. Easy. Who's on the phone? Is that Will on the phone?
Thought we Chad. Had Dustin Ferguson.
No, but Dustin Ferguson was on last week.
Are you serious?
Yeah, well, I'm calling you guys back. I just got a call from you.
Oh.
Hey, Dustin, how you doing?
Get off my show.
I heard Chad say Dustin, but it's supposed to be Will Crewdson.
We did you already.
Hey, Dustin, how you doing? We're going to kick you off now because he called the wrong person, but thanks so much for answering.
Yeah. And you know what? Say something. Okay. Now that you're here, plug something so I don't feel bad.
We have our Ghost House Indiegogo app, so come help us out with that.
There you go. Where is that? Send me the link on Facebook, and I'll share it on Twitter.
Where is it?
It's on my phone, but I'll send them the link.
Perfect.
Where?
It's on Facebook.
Can we go?
No, No, he doesn't understand. He doesn't know what it is. We got to go, though.
He's having a ghost show.
Sorry. No, he's having a ghost. He's trying to raise money for his movie on Indiegogo. You want to go to a raising movie money for a movie thing?
Yeah, I'll go naked. That's a raise something.
All right. I'm sorry. Sorry, Dustin. Okay. We'll see you again soon.
Take care, baby. Okay. Bye-bye.
Hey, Chad.
Chad, you're screwing up. I'm going to be screwed. You're going to have to come to Florida and
Chad, see if you can get Will Crewdson
on
the phone.
You know what it was?
You see what happens when you get married? It's all that pousse. It makes you stupid.
I'm crazy.
You know, my father used to say, too much sex makes you stupid.
That's so funny.
That's why I'm as dumb as they can.
Yeah, you know what? You said in your email that he said he added me, and that's not true. He didn't actually add me.
Will Crewdson?
Yeah.
See if you can send him a request. And send him a request. I'll see if he sent me an email. Send him a request and see if we can get on there because he told me he sent you one.
He might be sleeping. He's in England.
That's what England. I just saw.
Oh.
England is way ahead of us now. It's like 8 hours ahead, 9 hours.
Actually, it's it's like 8 o'clock at night there.
Yeah, sorry about that. I got to remember to delete your old emails.
The second guest is? Second guest is Rachel Alig.
Right.
Alig.
Again, with the last name he can't pronounce.
I don't know how you pronounce it.
Oh, you better go back to school, fourth in your class.
Be easy.
He said, tells me he graduated fourth in his class.
Sixth, actually.
Sixth. And there are words I use. He said, what does that mean? And me, I was kicked out of school at 16.
Oh, well.
You know, I was sixth in my class.
All right, everybody. So here's what we're going to do. We have to try and get Will Crewdson. We have to try to add him on.
I think I got him now. Will, are you there? Will, are you there? Hello, Will.
Yes.
Are you there?
Hey.
All right, cool.
Hey!
We just have a still picture of it.
Yeah,
hey, Will, hit the video. Here we go. Perfect. Here we go. Hold on. Here we go.
You got me now?
All right, we got him.
Yay!
We got you now.
Say something so we can see if we can hear you.
Something so we can see you can hear me.
There you go.
Yeah,
hello.
He sounds a little far away. Maybe come a little bit closer.
Our man behind the board. You come a little closer, he said.
You sound a little far away.
How close?
There you
go. Not nostril
there
close.
Go. Now
close.
We can see your pretty mug.
There you go.
Thanks.
All right, Jimbo, we're good to go.
All right, so we made a mistake and we called our guest from last week, and that's why you've been sitting there waiting. We called the wrong person.
I bet they were thrilled to have two exposures.
That's right, two exposures. So here we go. Now that I pronounce your last name Crewdson.
That's right, yeah.
All right, I'm just making sure. Ron's going to make fun of me because I don't know how to pronounce people's names, but
no,
I like to make sure.
He brags about being graduating sixth in his class at college, and he can't. He doesn't know anything. I got kicked out of school at 16 for yelling at a teacher, not teacher, bitch. And she grabbed me by the neck, and I spun around, and she spun around a few times, and she flew off and hit the wall. And they said that I attacked her. I never attacked her. She attacked me, the skinny little bitch. Anyway, they kicked me out of school.
You can say anything you want here, by the way, Will. But anyway, let's do a proper introduction.
They kicked me out of school, and I know more than he does. It just goes to show you, back in the 1950s, we learned better in school than these guys did in the 1970s.
That's not true. I want to make sure I'm pronouncing the names correctly because millions of people are going to see it, and I don't want people to like not for me to do it incorrectly.
He has difficulty with the name Smith.
No, I don't.
Well, no, that was right, 100% right, which is very unusual because my name's quite hard to pronounce. And,
Not for me.
A lot of confusion. So that's very good. Top notch.
All right, I love that top notch. I have to use that.
Listen, I know your last name is Crewdson.
Yeah. All right, everybody. Now we want to welcome to the Jimmy Star Show.
How many people tease you about it?
Let's do an intro so we can have all this on camera.
Shut up with that nasty little queen mouth of yours.
Come on, just stop. Bitch. All right. We do this all the time. Don't worry. It's normal. All right, everybody. Now we want to welcome...
I'm married to the bloke.
Okay, would you please let me do an intro? Thank you.
Would you please make this show happen because you're boring
I'm making it happen. Nobody knows who he is yet. We have to introduce him.
We know who he is. He's Joe Crewdson.
Yeah. All right, everybody. Now we want to welcome to the Jimmy Star Show with Ron Russell, one of the most celebrated and well-known and most popular guitarists in the music industry today, the fabulously talented Mr. Will Crewdson. Hello and welcome to the show.
Hi. Yeah.
How'd you like that intro?
That was quite an intro.
Yeah. It's all true, dude. Like, I actually Googled you today, besides the little teeny bio that you gave me that tells you almost nothing, you know. And then I Googled you, and your Wikipedia page is very impressive, and I took all kinds of notes because you're way too – I'm not modest, and I'm going to let you be modest, and I'm going to brag for you that you're like a badass fucking guitarist, dude, and like I think your career has been stellar so far. And we're going to talk about your career and your new album that's coming out, but you've really got some mad –
And also, Jimmy's a firm believer that when we were kids, bullshit makes the flowers grow.
Fair enough, fair enough.
No, okay,
so... Only kidding, only teasing.
Listen, you guys, no, here's the thing. Okay, so you guys, first of all, Will has... Actually, he's like in a million bands, and I had to look all these bands up, by the way, because I wasn't sure of some of them. But right now, he's in a band. He is Scant Regard, you guys. Their website is scantregard.com. He's got a new album. When's the new album coming out? It's called Skipping Over Damaged Area. When's it actually coming out?
Right, it's out this Monday, actually. And Scant Regard is my solo thing. It's just literally just me. So it's like a kind of pseudonym that I go under.
We're going to actually play songs. We're going to play songs from that in a minute. But you're also... You're the lead guitarist in the Animance band. You're in a band called The Selector, which we probably saw you then. Were you here when he played in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania? Were you on tour with him last year?
If it was last year, I would have done that. Yeah.
Yeah, so we would have been, because we were there.
We would have met you. We saw Adam.
The Glam Skanks opened up for you?
Oh, yeah. Adam. Yeah, sorry. I thought you were talking about Selector. Yes.
Adam. With Adam. I'm sorry.
No,
yes.
Yeah, I was with Adam all year. Yeah. So I would have been there. Absolutely.
You belong on our show. You're confused. I love it.
Yeah. It's not my job to be confused as Nigel. Sorry.
Yeah. So then you're in a band called The Selector. You're in a band called Rachel Stamp. And Rachel Stamp, I looked up. Rachel Stamp is one badass band. Like, I watched all the music videos. It's a great band. You guys look terrific. And I really, really enjoyed it a lot. And in Rachel Stamp, you guys play with Iggy Pop, Korn, No Doubt, The Tubes, Cheap Trick. I mean, all kinds. I mean, these are like not like little bands. These are like A-list, superstar bands. So you've really done a lot with that. You're also in a band named She Made Me Do It.
How'd you come up with that name?
Because basically it's kind of tongue in cheek.
It's all my idea. I like that. She made me do it. Tongue in cheek.
Hang on, let him answer.
A big collaboration with the female singer who also plays keyboards in Rachel Stamp, but she's Shahina. She's a singer, and we just thought it was funny. We just thought people would remember the name as well. You know, it's quite
absolutely. Kind of what's Adam Ant like? Give us some inside dirt on Adam.
Well, you've seen him on stage. He's still amazing. Yeah,
people, person from stage.
Yeah, yeah. So
the opposite. Adam is very outgoing on stage and quite the big star. In private life, I bet he's very quiet and introverted because most stars are.
Absolutely, yeah. It's very different off stage.
Is he still heartbroken because Eileen Shapiro refused to marry him?
Oh, well, obviously, yeah. I mean, that's just like the bane of his life, you know.
He was begging Eileen to marry him, and she said, "Get away, get away, get away. I'm going to I'm going to marry Bing Crosby."
Yeah.
That's so funny. By the way, which we met Will through Eileen. That's how he came on the show.
Oh, so you know Eileen Big Tits.
Eileen
Big Tits. Eileen Big Tits.
Of course he knows Eileen.
You know the girls, too. You see the girls all the time. You can't miss them. You see Eileen. Here she comes. I see the girls coming before I see Eileen.
He's talking about her tits when he says the girls.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah, no, seriously.
You're positive they're female,
No, really. When Eileen walks...
You said you're positive they're female.
When Eileen walks towards you, you see them before her.
You've met Eileen in person, though, right?
I have, yeah, a few times.
Okay,
good.
Isn't she the best? We love and adore her.
She's great, yeah. Amazing.
She's like my sweetest, dearest friend in New York. I love her. I love her.
Oh, we want to say hi to Aaron Paul's in the chat room because he said he was at that show with us when we saw Adam Ann in Pennsylvania.
Oh, so she came into the show, the little tramp.
So hold on. So, okay,
I got to talk to Aaron.
No, that's after the interview. You don't talk to Aaron in the middle of his interview.
Yeah, I do because he's going to be interested in what I have to say.
Okay.
If Aaron came. No, not really. I mean, Aaron, you bitch. I love you.
Okay, forget it. So also then, you also, because I took this now, this might be some of this. I only wrote down the bands that I like really know. But also, you play guitar for the following, and I took this off of your Wikipedia page. Bow Wow Wow, Malcolm McLaren, Tom Jones.
Tom Jones
is like my absolute fucking favorite.
No, Malcolm.
Brian Ferry, Celine Dion. We don't really like her that much. No. And Billy Bragg. Like you are like, so you're like really like, you're like rock star royalty.
Oh, wait, hold it. Go back to Clarence. I love him. He died, didn't he, Malcolm?
He did. About 8 years ago, he died, yeah.
He did die. Oh, yeah. I used to love his album, Fans, F-A-N-S, remember?
And all right.
Opera song that was in it that he did. Ooh, the Chinese thing was gorgeous.
Let's talk about it.
What was he like?
He was great. I mean, that was literally, I was about 19 when I worked with him, and it was just for one track, which was, I don't know if you remember, there was a Carry On film called Carry On Columbus.
Yes, I love all the Carry Ons I watched.
Yeah, it's probably the last one they made, and they kind of got Malcolm to do the soundtrack, and he needed some guitar on it. So I did it, and I couldn't tell if he was impressed or not. You know, he almost dismissed me from the studio. He ended up using everything I'd recorded, so I take that as a compliment.
Absolutely,
it's hard to kind of gauge it, and because I was so young, and it was the first.
He was kind
session.
Of a prima donna, then, right?
You don't look a lot older than 19 now, though.
Well, yeah, it was only a couple of years ago, yeah. Oh no! But yeah,
now, what was Tom Jones like? Did you ever see him put the dish rag in his pants? The he rolled up.
No, he was in his cotton wool period when I worked with him. Actually,
oh, because that's the standard. That was the standard joke in Las Vegas that he rolled up a face towel and put it in his pants.
Okay, well, I didn't notice that myself. I was more engaged with playing my guitar. But no, he was great to work with. Did a lot of TV.
I sweated you out in that one.
It's funny because I saw Tom Jones in Vegas many years ago. It had to be 15 years ago or something in Vegas, and like all the ladies were throwing their panties and bras up on the stage, awesome.
That was not for real, by the way. That was done deliberately by special people that he had given money to do that. It was all PR. Nobody threw their.
He's like the biggest star in the war in England. He's like such a huge
Tom
star.
Tom Jones, I couldn't stomach him. Couldn't stand looking at him. He was a conceited.
He's a judge on The Voice. I love him.
I don't care. He's got an attitude. He thinks he's gorgeous, and he had a bad skin pockmark. It reminded me of Richard Burton, another ugly thing. You know, so I never liked Tom Jones.
Well, maybe it's to do with being Welsh. They're both Welsh, you know, Richard Burton.
Yeah, Welsh, they have bad skin because the coal from the mines, it goes in their pores. Their face.
Let me ask you a question. Being a musician, because like I said, I watched The Voice, the UK version of The Voice and X Factor and all that stuff. I have to watch it like in replays on YouTube. But being like a real musician and not like a karaoke musician, do you ever watch any of those shows?
Well, I don't have a TV on purpose, so I kind of avoid all this kind of stuff. But I see occasional little clips of it, and it's normally the most outrageous things that get put on YouTube, isn't it? So,
yes.
But I don't know. I mean, I wouldn't even know he was presenting it these days.
Why don't you have a TV?
Because I just don't have time. Because you've seen how many bands I'm in.
Yes.
And I never have the urge. Even if I'm in a hotel, I never have the urge to put a TV on because I'm not used to having one anymore. So.
Oh my gosh, yeah. That's have like all these like groupies chasing you around for sex.
No.
No,
you blew that. You should have all kinds of. Well, are you married? Maybe you're married.
No. What you do is you get a face towel, roll it up, and put it in your pants, and then you'll have them jumping all over you like they do Tom Jones.
Okay.
He's like, holy shit.
The only thing is,
when you do the washing up, what are you going to use for that?
Well, that's what it's all about. You say to the chick, listen, I carry my own face rag with me.
So who are some of your musical like influences then that I mean, have you played with most of your musical influences? Like you play in such different kinds of bands and everything. Like when you were growing up, who would be like, oh my god, I love this band? Who was like some of your influences growing up?
Well, I mean, Adam and the Ants was the first band I ever saw, so that was a massive initial kind of influence. And I have worked with quite a lot of the people that I admire, you know, and I kind of make a point to try and force myself on them, like I did with Adam, to say, look, I'm right for your band because I know all your songs, you know. So, yeah, Adam was a big one. But then there's a lot of electronic stuff I loved in the 80s, like Depeche Mode and...
Yeah, Depeche Mode.
Awesome. ...and stuff like that. And I kind of, like, with my Scant Regard stuff, it kind of crosses over a bit with the electronic stuff that I love, you know, but I try and mix it with my guitar playing, you know.
So your Scant Regard stuff too, though, is very, a lot of it sounds very soundtracky. Like I could see a lot of it being in movies. Like, have you placed any of your songs in any movies?
Yeah, no, I mean, I'm trying. I just kind of, when I do the tracks, I think of a movie, you know, a movie in my mind's eye and try and make a track out of that, you know, but that's where it comes from. Absolutely. If anyone wants to use it, then they're very, you know, they're very welcome.
Oh, you know what? You need to send me an email to remind me because I have a list of all the music supervisors who pick all the music for all the TV shows and all the movies in the United States, and I'll give you the directory and you can contact them. It costs a fortune, so don't share it, but I'll give it to you.
Yeah, just type it on here.
Yes. Yeah,
that's great.
So Scant Regard, as you're coming out with your fifth album, coming out on Monday. It's called Skipping Over Damaged Area, because we're going to play a song from it. And I wrote down that the overall theme of the album is apocalyptic destruction and the devolution of the planet we live on.
Told you he doesn't know anything. Devolution. I mean, devolution.
I don't know. How do you pronounce it? Is it devolution or devolution?
I would say, thinking about the band Devo, I would say it's devolution.
Okay, devolution. See?
But first you said devolution.
Well, I wasn't sure because it's Sixth spelled the same as revolution.
Sixth in
it's
a square.
Yeah.
You know, Florida, the educational system stinks anyway, but he was sixth in his class.
Right.
No, seriously, New York had a wonderful education system, and Florida, they used to say, was ugh. A lot of people that lived in Florida sent their kids to private schools because the schools were so bad. Sixth in his class.
He's just picking on me. Sixth in my class out of 30-something thousand students. Anyway, so you have this album, and hey, Chad, can you get the song that I sent you ready?
I got it ready.
All right, so here's what I did.
I want to ask him one question.
Okay.
Did you ever think of doing a solo guitar album of just guitar music? You know, it's been done, and I love it. There's an album you should get that Johnny Mathis sings. It's Open Fire with two guitars. It's just two guitars, and the music is unbelievable. It's
actually, hold on. Ask him. Have you heard of Johnny Mathis? Do you know who Johnny Mathis is?
Yeah.
Listen
is
to the music.
Around?
Yes.
In fact, a famous rock and roll group, I forgot the name, wrote one of the songs for it. Open Fire with two guitars, standing, sitting by an open fire, watching flames as they grow higher. That one. I forgot the name of it. That one is brilliant, but the guitar playing is, it's... Bet. I forgot who the guitarists were, but they were very world famous at the time.
I
have to tell you too, Will.
You'll love the album.
In the chat room, they're going crazy. They say they want to go out with you. They love the way you look. They love your music.
Whoa,
I want to party with him. Like, this guy is awesome.
Whoa.
I'm just reading the chat room. They all freaking like love you in the chat room. So if you want groupies, we could probably work it out.
Now, if you really want them to go crazy, stand up, pull down your pants, show them your penis. Show them your penis, they'll really go after
face rag then, wouldn't I?
So hold on. So you have a new song. First of all, you have the new album. It's called Skipping Over Damaged Area. And I actually like the song Fuck Everything, but we're not playing it because I was afraid the station would get mad since it says Fuck Everything a bunch. I thought that the owner of the station and iHeartRadio might not like it. So we're not going to play it, but I'm going to tell everybody that they have to download the song when it comes out because it's really cool. And the song But the song that I picked that I really liked a lot is Car Crash on Pluto. So that's the song I've decided that we're going to play for everybody. And Chad's got it. So how about if you do this? You say who you are and the name of the band and everything and introduce the song for us, and then we're going to play it for everybody to hear.
Okay, sure. My name is Will Crewdson from Scant Regard, and this is Car Crash on Pluto.
Perfecto. Now he's going to play.
There you go.
All right, everybody. So that was Will Crewdson, and he is known as Scant Regard, and the name of the song was Car Crash on Pluto, and that was a world exclusive, you guys, off the brand new album Skipping Over Damaged Area. It's coming out on Monday. And if you're in the UK, he's playing Friday night at the Hope and Anchor. Where is that? What town is that in?
That's in London. It's in Islington, North London. So,
there you go. So Friday night, you guys go see Scant Regard. Do you like to go by Scant Regard, or do you go by your name, or you go by Scant Regard when you're playing those shows, and your name on other shows?
I never go under my name unless I'm playing with someone else. You know, so it's just Scant Regard is the name I go by when I play on my own. Yeah.
All right. So everybody go check out Scant Regard, not Will Crewdson. Friday night at Hope and Anchor in Islington.
I'm like Kraftwerk. I'll just send a robot down there. You know, I would if I could.
You got to love it. Also, you guys, Scant Regard has a website. You can go to www.scantregard.com and you can follow Will on Twitter at Will Crewdson. And then what's Scant Regard has a Twitter too, right? At Scant Regard?
Right, yeah. Got at Scant Regard as well, yeah.
So you guys follow both of them. And actually, all his bands have the Selector, Rachel Stamp. I think they all have Twitter. So look them all up, follow all of them, and see what's going on with him. All right, so you got any weird questions you want to ask him?
Yeah, when are you marrying this girl you're going out with for such a long time? If I were a father, I'd kick your ass right out of the house and tell you, if you go near my daughter, I'll cut your balls off. Because to take the youth away from a beautiful girl is sinful. And how long have you been going out with her?
Oh, about 18 years.
Oh, well, wait, I cut your throat. 18 years?
They're married anyway.
Oh, come on. Give that poor girl a name. What the fuck is wrong with you? I mean, 18 years? Nobody's going to want her anymore. After you get through with her and you go on to some tomato with fake tits and bleach blonde
hair. He's not going with anywhere. He's 18 years, that's married.
When you marry some sleazy pole dancing slut, that's what they always do. The good girls get dumped. They wait 18 years for the man, then they get dumped, and the guy marries some chick with rubber balls, rubber balloon tits, swinging from a pole in a cheesy bar with dollar bills up a clip.
What?
Okay. Now listen, she's a nice girl. Shut up, I'm upset. She's a nice girl?
Of course she is. Yeah. He wouldn't be waiting for 18 years.
Wait a minute, and you're in love with her?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, marry
her. Does she go on tour with you?
No, she sings in She Made Me Do It. She's the singer.
Oh, she's in one of your bands, so you work with her, too.
Oh, the poor thing. She's even a slave.
She Made Me Do It. Listen to the title.
That's the name of the group is She Made Me Do It, and she's in the band.
I only hope she castrates you one day. No, seriously. I really believe in marriage. I married this creature next to me.
Oh, excellent. Know, well,
I don't know why I married him. I must have had a moment, you know. It was an LSD flashback moment.
That was terrible. Okay, so let's do bucket list. So now you played with all these like cool bands. Now if Scant Regard was going on a world tour and you could play with any other artists on the planet, like try and pick somebody you haven't already played with because that doesn't make it any fun. Who would Scant Regard like to go on tour with?
I'd love to play with Depeche Mode. I'd love to play with Trent Reznor or someone like that, you know, someone that's really, you know.
That was totally going to be my pick. In my head, I was like, I think Trent Reznor or Depeche Mode, so you answered both the two. I love, especially early Depeche Mode, when I was in college in, like, the mid-80s, where they did, like, People Are People and Blasphemous Rumors and all that stuff. I love that back in the day. I thought Depeche Mode. And I saw them in concert with New Order, and they were awesome.
Yeah, still great now. Yeah, absolutely.
Absolutely. Did you like New Order? I love New Order.
Yeah, I love New Order. And the Cure.
Okay. And then
did you ever hear of Lawrence Welk?
I bet he doesn't even know who Lawrence Welk is.
Did you ever hear of Lawrence Welk was this old guy that used to play on television every week, and it was like oom-pa-pa music, oom-pa-pa, oom-pa-pa, oom-pa. I mean, really crappy, old, shitty, boring stuff. And people loved him. And the women used to go crazy over Lawrence Welk. He's like a joke in the music business.
But it was like symphony music or something. Orchestra music. That's it. Thanks, Chad.
No, it was music from the turn of the century.
Big band, Santa,
don't you cry for me.
Big band.
I come from Alabama with
the banjo. No, he didn't do that.
Yes, they did. They did all that hokey shit.
Lawrence Welk was on before Hee Haw when I was little.
My mother loved Lawrence Welk.
He doesn't. He's like, what the fuck are you guys talking about? I have no idea what the fuck. He doesn't watch TV in the first place. He's not going to know some TV show from 50 years ago when he's only like 20 years old.
the Brits won't get it, but the Americans will.
Okay.
So we got to let the Americans in on something here. It just can't be an all Brit show. You know?
Do you come to America like as Scant Regard? Have you been to America playing anywhere as Scant Regard yet?
Yeah, I actually played a couple of gigs last year in LA with Glam Skanks, one of them.
Oh, yes.
They were great. They're always great. And So yeah, I did, and I've done that. I did LA a few years ago. Actually, the first gig I ever played was in LA because I didn't want my friends to know I was doing this new solo thing. And I thought, well, I'll do it somewhere else, and I did it.
That way, in case it sucked, you wouldn't have had to worry about it. But luckily, it was good, and you're five albums into it. So
yeah, but LA was a bad choice because that's a big mouth town.
I know, but not with his friends because his friends are in the UK.
It doesn't matter. LA, you know, gets it out there. If you stink in LA, it's like New York. If you bomb in New York, you bomb the whole world. The word gets around.
We love the Glam Skanks, though. We've had them on two or three times. We've had them on.
I love them. I love my drummer.
Yeah, the drummer's badass.
I love the drummer. She's incredible. She's fabulous. She's beautiful. She's sweet, and she's a gay girl, and she's so gorgeous. And if I were a gay woman, I would wrap my legs around her face. She's so beautiful.
Wrap my legs around her face.
She is so beautiful, and I love her so much.
You got to love it.
All the glam skanks. You know who's
nice?
Yeah,
she's a great drummer.
And the glam skanks' parents, what's her name? The mother and father, Dolls. Did you ever meet them?
Oh, V's parents, the guitarist?
Sweetie pies? They're really lovely people.
Oh, you're talking about the singer, which I think they got rid of her now. I think so she's not there anymore.
Why?
Didn't the Glam Skanks get a new singer?
The singer's parents used to come over to the UK and see them and stuff.
Yeah. Yeah. Yes. They're fabulous.
Everybody out there, if they're playing with the Glam Skanks, go see them. They're great. How come they're not like super famous like Adam Ant? They should be as good as
Adam
Ant's
been around for 40 years or something.
I know. Well, you know, it's time to leave Adam and let's get that Glamour Skanks a chance. My father used to say that all the time. He'd watch television and he'd see people like Jack Benny or George Burns. These are very old actors. And my father would say, die already. Make room for a young one, you old bags. How much do you want to be there? And I thought that was so cynical.
So wait, were you born in the 80s? Were you like listening to music in the 80s? Because you don't look very old, but if you had a girlfriend for 18 years, you have to be at least in your like mid to late 30s.
Well, it could have been like, you know, child love.
No. Because like, no, literally, I was on YouTube last night, like looking at like all the new, like the new romantics, like artists to see who we could invite on the show, like ABC and Go West and Spandau Ballet And I even invited Dexy's Midnight Runner, the ones who sing Come On Eileen, because I thought we could have them come on and have Eileen come on at the same time.
I mean, I think that's,
brilliant.
You know,
that'd be great.
I told Eileen to send that song to Sam Stevens. You know who's Sam Stevens?
No, she doesn't. He doesn't know. He might not know Sam. Do you know Sam, Eileen?
The latest gossip you don't know? Oh, my dear. Listen up. Eileen and Sam Stevens got a thing going there.
Oh, you're going to see. You're going to meet Sam Friday night because if Eileen's coming to the show, I guarantee Sam will be with her. So you'll get to see him.
I thought he was performing somewhere.
He is performing, but not with Will. Not with Scant Regard. Sorry, I don't want to mess up the names.
Is he on the same bill?
No.
Oh, Sam's not working that night. Anyway, that's Eileen's heartthrob. Adam, she's over with Adam.
He's playing at Mau Mau. Yeah. He's playing at like Mau Mau in a couple of places while Eileen's there.
But she's done with Adam, and she's gone on to Sam Stevens. And we sent him the music, Come On Eileen.
What are you going to do? You got to like love it. We played it a couple of weeks ago.
I am such a nasty devil. I really am.
That's right.
You know,
you're
a
pig.
I never grew up. I used to be this way when I was 17. I never grew up.
All right. So what other shows or what other things you want to like promote real quick while we got you on? You got any other shows coming up?
Yeah, I've got a few. I've got I'm playing with a Depeche Mode tribute band, which is the nearest I can get to playing with Depeche Mode.
Okay.
And that's at The Underworld on May the 15th, and they're called Strange Love. They're actually based in LA, and they're coming over, called Strange Love. I'm playing with the Glam Skanks on June the 10th.
We love them.
Please send kisses from me to all of them.
Yeah, we love
Tell
them.
Ron Russell says big juicy kisses.
Absolutely. So I'm playing with them June the 10th, Lexington. Another band called Tokyo Taboo, who look really fun and exciting. So I'm looking forward to seeing them. And I'm playing the Subterranea on May the 7th, which is West London, this Portobello Live Festival. And with She Made Me Do It, I'm playing 2nd of June at the Electra Works in London. All these are in London, really.
They're making a ton
of... I've got one in St Albans, May the 6th, with a brilliant band called The Tuesday Club. So, yeah.
I have a question,
You're making a lot of money. You can afford a wedding.
No, I'm not making any money.
Bullshit.
I'm not.
Musicians don't make a lot of money.
Nah. It's all, no one buys music anymore. That's the problem.
You're right. That is a problem. What do you think of that? Like, what do you think of the whole streaming plasm from a, being a well-known musician? Like, what do you think of, like, Spotify? Like, I read this thing that, like, 15 on Spotify, your song has to get 15,000 streams for it to equal to one download. I mean, that doesn't seem fair.
Nah, it's kind of, I mean, if you're in my position, I'm still trying to break my own stuff through, and it's great. You know, people can have access to your music quite easily now. So, I mean, to me, it's all about playing live anyway. And if you can get people to come see you live from them,
that's how you make money.
I believe it was Stevie Nicks that said the reason for vinyl now is the style of having vinyl records is that you have to buy them. You can't steal them.
Yeah.
So if you want Stevie Nicks on vinyl, you have to buy her album. And they're like $20 or more. So put your work on vinyl. Screw the other ones.
Yeah.
Very expensive to do that, though.
It is quite expensive to do vinyl these days, yeah. But, no, I still like CDs, really. They're easy to send out to people.
Yes, absolutely. I think it's too bad, but you know what, too? Nowadays, well, I don't know about it in the UK. Like, I drive a Jeep. I don't even know if they have Jeeps in the UK, but I drive a Jeep and it's 2 years old, and it doesn't even come with a CD player. It only comes with a thing to plug in your phone for music or your iPod or something like that. But I can't even play a CD in my car. You know, I have to put it on my computer and then put it in my iTunes library for me to be able to play it in my car,
or
which I think is jacked up.
In my car, because I drive a vintage 04 Audi TT Roadster in bright yellow convertible.
Nice.
So when we blast my music, which would probably be Johnny Mantis singing, "It's wonderful, wonderful, oh, so wonderful, my love," people turn around and they look and they give me the high, you know, sign, because my music is wonderful music.
Right.
My music, the lyrics are beautiful. Women are beautiful. Love is beautiful. Today, women are bitches. Beat them, smack them, shoot them, kill them, stab them. And then
that's only hip-hop.
And then dump them. There are no more lyrics in music that are romantic. You know, the very few songs you can sing, like your music, what is it? Kill somebody in Pluto? Run them over or something? What is it? Drive over them in Pluto? His album.
No, his song is Skipping Over Damaged Area, and the name of the song was Car Crash on Pluto.
Okay, Car Crash on Pluto. Is that like you and your girlfriend are in a car and you crash?
It's electronic music. You didn't listen to it.
I can't hear it. Chad doesn't send it to us. I'm going to play it.
Now it's Chad's fault.
No, I'm going to hear it and talk about it next week.
But it's electronic music, so his music is different.
I love electronic music.
I know. He will love it, actually.
You know that. I love club music. I love and adore club music. So I know I'm going to love your music, and I know I'm going to love your guitar without even hearing
it. Well, his guitar's not in his electronic music because it's electronic music.
Well, you do an electronic guitar.
There is guitar on it. There's a lot of guitar on it as well.
Yeah, see, Jimmy, you know your ass from your elbow. Sixth in his class, really. But, I mean, I wish they would go back to some romantic ballad. You know, like soul music years ago when black people would sing all those gorgeous, sexy, beautiful. I can't think of one performer, and I love them all. Patti LaBelle, for an example. I mean.
Right.
Wait, do you listen to any R&B music coming out of the UK ever?
Not new stuff, really. I wouldn't really know any new stuff, R&B. I'm stuck in the 80s, really. I love Cameo and stuff like that, and Prince, and
yes,
you know, all that stuff.
What do you think of Roger Daltrey's return to the world? He's appearing all over the place, concerts. He had a big television show the other night here in America, and he did all the music that he did in the movie.
Tommy.
Oh, okay. Well, that's cool.
That's old music, and you got to see the people in the audience, thousands of them going crazy and screaming and yelling from such old music.
That's great. I mean, if he's still got it, if he can still get out there and do it, he should be doing it, because that's what he does best.
He's an old man now.
Better than the trout farming he does.
That's why I like Martin Fry, though. I like him in ABC. I like watched a lot of their videos. But real quick, there's a singer who followed you on Twitter. Her name's Hannah Clive. She's in the UK. She says, get in touch with her after the show, so follow her after the show so you can tweet with her. She's super cool. She's been on the show a bunch of times, and she also works with a band called I Am Warface.
Yeah, we like her.
But we like her. She's cool.
We like her a lot.
So here's what we got, everybody. This is Will Crewdson, who's also known as Scant Regard, who's also in Adam Ant's band, The Selector, Rachel Stamp, She Made Me Do It. He's played with all kinds of millions of super great bands. His new album is Skipping Over Damaged Area. It's his fifth album. It's coming out on Monday. You got to hear the world premiere of Car Crash on Pluto. And if you want to hear a really fun song, it's got to listen to – actually, we want you to download the whole album. He's an indie artist. He needs to make money. He makes money if you buy his stuff. So buy the whole album.
Don't be cheesy and steal it.
So buy the whole album, and especially you want to play Over and Over, Fuck Everything, because I loved it. I just thought it was great.
Remember one thing. His girlfriend is 18 years with him, and the poor bitch is waiting to get married. So send him money. This way he can marry her and buy a little house.
If he sells a million downloads of a $10 album, you guys, he can finally get married. Yeah, so let's do it.
He can buy a little attached flat in downtown London. He can have china and silver and a nice teapot to give tea to everybody. You know.
I bet he doesn't drink tea. Do you drink tea?
No, I just drink coffee all the time, black coffee.
You know, when I was in London, listen, when I was in London, because I go quite a lot, when I was there last, I went crazy looking for the ball to put the tea in. They didn't have them anymore. You know, the round ball, you put the tea in.
The strainer, the chain.
Yeah. Well, finally, in an antique store, I found one, and I have one. And when I make tea, I put my tea in the ball and drop it in the pot. And I learned all the tricks about the cozy you have to put on the teapot. There's a lot of tricks to making tea in England. So this is not like here, you get a bag of Lipton's and dump it in the water.
Yeah, and it's a big...
Big to do, and I love all the stuff that goes with it, the crumpets. And
Hannah Clive said the first tour she did in the USA was with Roger Daltrey, and he was singing the music of The Who with an orchestra.
Yeah, well, you know, I was impressed. I mean, he's old, he's got white hair, he's short and dumpy looking, but he's – no, I mean, really, but he used to be a tiny little thin boy, and now he's like –
She said he was fit then.
Well, he's still fit. He's just short and dumpy, isn't he? You know, you lose that boy body.
I got that dump, too. No, I can't complain.
Listen, Roger's my age, or very close to my age. He's in his 70s, like I am. He's from my day. And
he's 77.
I'll be 78. In May, I'll be 78, yeah. That's because I let a lot of women sit on my face for years.
Wow.
I did, and it's very good. Very good for the skin. So let your girlfriend sit on your face at least 2 hours a night, and you'll never age. But anyway, Roger, I thought, was wonderful, and I loved the music from Tommy anyway, especially the slot, the pinball thing, and it was great. Yeah. So, yeah, Roger, everybody, go see his concert. He's really good still.
All right, everybody, so this is it. Check out scantregard.com. Follow at Will Crewdson and at scantregard on Twitter. We wish you all the luck with it. Have a great time Friday night. Enjoy Eileen. You'll meet Sam. He's a super nice guy living in the UK. We want to thank you for coming on the show. We had a blast. We loved it. Say hi to your girlfriend. We were joking around, but we wish you all the best with her.
Give my Eileen a big kiss from me. And listen.
Yeah.
Girl, I'm really happy. Give her your last name. Croutons.
Tell you what, if we got married, the last thing she'd want is my name, because you can even pronounce it properly. She wouldn't want that.
Just say croutons. Everybody knows what croutons are. They're in a salad. It's so easy.
That's stooped up, I think.
But anyway, you're a delightful person. I'd love to meet you one day over the pond or here. We will meet, because we're all in the same insane business. But anyway, enjoy your lovely girlfriend of 8. She must be something special, boy, to keep you crazy for 18 years.
Absolutely.
And tell her that I wish her the best of luck.
And good luck with all the bands, and especially Scant Regard and She Made Me Do It, since she's in that band.
And when you see Adam Ant, be sure to tell him that Eileen has found somebody else.
I'll make a point.
He missed the boat. That's all. Thank you,
Will. Have a good one.
Willie. Take care, Willie.
Bye-bye. Not Willie, Will.
Will, Willie. I know him well. Now, in Brooklyn, we called everybody Billy, Joey, Ronnie, and he's Willie.
And he hangs up quick on that one.
We didn't hang up. We cut him off, you little faggot.
They loved him, though.
He's a sweet guy with a nice sense of humor.
So, Chad, you haven't gotten our next guest?
I do now.
Okay, good. Yep. So it's too early, but we'll call her in a minute.
One on top of another. I need to breathe.
We'll call her in a minute.
We have some.
No. too noisy.
You know, the air conditioning in the studio now, we have to do something because it makes a hum.
I can't hear it.
It makes a hum.
Actually, I can't hear it at all.
We don't have it on. I turned it off because it was too noisy.
But I'm sure that our people love us enough to say, don't roast your nuts off. Put the friggin' air conditioner on.
We only got 40 minutes
to go. We could live with the hum.
No, the hum's... Actually, we can play it and let Chad hear it and see how bad it is.
It's not bad. It's in his mental illness that he hears.
No, it's really loud. Because did a test Skype and I could hear it in the background.
Mentally ill people hear humming.
No, you just don't hear
always. We'll do a sound check next week with the mics on and see if I can hear it.
We'll do it. Okay.
Because usually when you have a microphone, it won't pick up, you know, too far away. It'll only pick up close, so we'll do a sound check next week.
Yeah, we're probably going to go with the lavaliers.
I don't want you guys to be like sweating.
I'll encross Jimmy's lavalier in rhinestones and pink stones, so it looks like a big necklace.
Well, he's a star.
Because he doesn't want to wear the lavalier. It ruins his outfit.
What?
That's not true.
You're supposed to like hide it somewhere in your outfit. But anyhow.
Oh, it ruins you.
We'll work
it out.
Wear
a wig, Mike. Wig mic. I put a wig mic in my hair.
There you go.
So listen up.
I used to wear wig mics did my drag show.
I want to play like a song for everybody. So you guys know, like, we're big fans. We love Ricky Rebel. He's a really cool guy.
Oh,
and Ricky Rebel was in a boy band called No Authority back in the day.
Is Ricky in?
And
is Ricky here?
No.
Ricky, I love you wherever you are. You
but in the meantime, you guys, Ricky was in this band called No Authority. It was a boy band. You know, I'm like the boy band authority. I knew every freaking boy band.
Pedophile.
I just like boy bands. So this is the song that they hit big with. It's called Can I Get Your Number? And it's an old video because, like, Ricky's like 16 in it or something. And so it's an old video and the quality's not that great, but you can hear the song. And I thought we'd take a quick break, play that, come back. Do a little ad for where you can hear us, and then we'll call our next guest. So here it is, everybody. No Authority featuring Ricky Rebel, who
the
used
best.
To be.
Ricky Rebel then, is the best.
And then the name of the song is Can I Get Your Number? Enjoy.
Can I get your number? Something about your smile.
All right, Jimbo, there you go.
We can hear you.
Oh, hello. I'm here.
There you go. Okay, good, you guys. So real quick, you guys, that video was No Authority. Can I Get Your Number featuring Ricky Rebel, one of our favorite entertainers on the planet?
Yes, Ricky
you guys
Rebel
will like love it.
Never be missed. His performances are outrageous.
There you go. So now what you guys, here's what we're going to do. We're going to – I have to do a quick commercial, so Rachel, just hang on there for a second.
Cool.
I just want to tell Rachel, before I went on Twitter, I went from 1,600 fans to 22,000 in no time on Twitter. You've got to go on Twitter.
Yeah, you
got
to get on Twitter.
You've got to go on Twitter.
We'll talk about that then in a minute. Let me just
You'll be amazed.
Normally, you guys, we call our guests at 4:15, and so we have 4 minutes, and I just got to tell everybody where you can hear us every week, and then we're going to come back to our lovely guest, who's looking absolutely gorgeous and fabulous, and she's super talented, so we're coming back to her in a minute. But every week, you guys, you can hear the Jimmy Star Show with Ron Russell on W4CY Radio with the fabulously talented Chad Murphy.
And what a pleasure it is.
Ho, 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 ho.
You can hear us on Hamilton Radio in New Jersey, Monster FM Radio in New York, K4HD Radio in L.A., Jackalope Radio in St. Louis, Caliber Radio in South Carolina, Society's Basement Radio on iHeartRadio, Stitcher, SoundCloud, iTunes, Audio Boom, Apple TV, Spreaker, and Podbean, and on television. You can see us on Vimeo, Roku, and YouTube.
We're
oh,
like
my
the,
God.
We're
man,
like the
breathe,
clap.
Breathe.
We're all over.
Yeah, I was going to say like flies on shit or something.
No, we're like the clap all over. Be careful of the clap. Anyway.
All right, everybody. Now we want to welcome to the Jimmy Star Show with Ron Russell, the incredibly beautiful and talented Rachel Alig. Hello and welcome to the show.
Hello. Thank you for having me.
It's so much fun. Before we get started, let me introduce you to everybody, starting off with my cool, outrageous man about town co-host, Mr. Ron Russell.
What's with all you beautiful girls that have the same smile? The girl we had last week had your smile with your teeth. Another beauty. I said on the show, I have no smile. You don't even see my teeth when I smile. Look. I look like shit. I want your mouth and your teeth and your smile.
Thank you.
It's beautiful. So you could do toothpaste there. What'd you say?
Huh? Say it again for him.
Let your teeth shine through.
Let your teeth shine through.
Oh,
he doesn't like to do that. He's never done that.
Anyway, you could do toothpaste commercials.
Hold on. So we've also got the man behind the boards, Mr. Chad Murphy.
Hey, Rachel. Welcome to the show. The boys are right. You are beautiful.
Oh, thank you so much. Yeah. I appreciate it.
Good to have you.
Yeah, but he just got married. So he's looking to cheat already.
Oh,
right. He got married a month ago. It's over. Like now, it's time to say you're the beautiful one.
Shut up.
By the
Ron.
Way, too, you know that when you get a compliment from Ron and I, that it's a true compliment.
Oh yeah.
Because we're gay and we're married, and
yeah.
so whenever you get a compliment from a gay guy, it's a real compliment because you know they're not trying to get anywhere with
we're
you.
We're not looking for pussy.
We're not looking to get anywhere. We're
not
just, like,
looking.
Making it.
We're not looking for pussy. That's for sure.
So we have a chat room full of people, and literally we have the UK, Estonia, Germany, Ireland, the United States, Canada, almost every like country is represented right now.
Plus over 4.5 million idiots that watch this stupid crappy show. I can't believe it. I cannot believe it. In this
I was going to have her say hi to all of them.
No, who wants to hear her talk?
She does.
In this country, we listen and look at everything. We don't care what it is, what the quality is. It could be garbage, and we love it.
But we want you to say hi to everybody in the chat room because every country is tuned in and listening to you
yes,
right now.
And
they're all remarking how gorgeous you are.
Yes, and we
want
to know.
Oh, my gosh. Thank you. Hello, everybody. Hello, Germany. Hello, Austria. Hello, Estonia.
There you go. You got to like, love it.
Say hello, world. Anyway.
So listen, you guys.
Wait, I have to ask the important question.
Okay.
Oh, no.
Why are you here and what do you do?
He knows nothing about you, by the way. I book all the guests.
I never, ever research a guest because I like it to be like I met you for the first time. So I get the most dirt out of you.
Well, then it's like a real conversation, right?
Well, that's what we are. We're not an interview show like most. We're a conversation show. Like I always say, make believe you're in my kitchen having Entenmann's crumb cake and coffee with me.
Oh my gosh, Entenmann's! I would love that right now.
The crumb cake with the white powdered sugar.
Like the extra thick crumb
with
cake.
The crust. I want to kill myself. Yes, let's suicide together.
In like 10 years, because it would go straight to my ass. But
I don't care if it went to my ass. I wouldn't care. I love Entenmann's crumb cake. You know, Fran Drescher, the nanny?
Yes.
I both love Entenmann's crumb cake. We have that in common.
I mean,
we had it on our show.
You don't like that.
Fran was on our show and we talked about it. It's her favorite. It's her favorite, too. You dunk the Entenmann's into the coffee and put it in your mouth before it falls off and goes in the cup.
Oh, yeah. Got to have it a little warm.
That's good. All right. Now, what do you do for a living besides looking beautiful and modeling, I guess?
No, actually, modeling is not really my area of expertise. I'm an actress. I do it full time. I make a living doing it. And I feel very, very fortunate that that's the case.
I think first of all, I think that's the coolest thing ever because we have a lot of up-and-coming actors. Then we have a lot of, like, so huge actors, you know, that everybody knows they support themselves. But I think it's really cool that you work in a lot of independent productions and stuff and you do well enough to be able to support yourself. And you're working with some really, like, A-notch names in some of these movies that you've just done and you have coming out. Because we're going to talk about At Granny's House in a little bit. And you have Bill Oberst, who was on our show about 6 months ago. You know, is the lead in that with you.
Yeah.
And, I mean, he's a multiple Emmy-winning actor.
Like you, I'm an actor for 57 years.
Don't scratch your
and
head.
And I supported myself as a hairdresser. 57 years. And I'm on this stupid show, and I'm still not making any money. I have a wonderful record of being the only actor who never got paid and has the longest career of anybody.
No, I love it,
there's
though.
And out there.
And you're also not pigeonholed. Like, at first I was because I went through your whole IMDb thing today because I find that a lot of actresses that are that we've had on the show lots of times that you would know, you know, they're pigeonholed. Like, they do a lot of horror, and you've done some horror, but that's not the only thing that you've done. And they get pigeonholed, and then there's Scream Queens, which is great. You can make a great living at it, but it's very difficult to break out of once you do too much of it. And you, I noticed with your career, you know, you've got a little bit of everything in there. And most of your credits, you're in the top two or three or four people leads in all mall. Because I look at that, too. Are you, like, you know, are you all at the back of the end of the cast credits, or are you at the beginning? And you're at the beginning of the cast credits at almost everything you're in. So congratulations.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, I think there's a... It requires a concerted effort so that you don't get pigeonholed. And you're right. There are many males and females that make a living in that genre. And then, you know, if they can become a scream queen. And it's a good career. I want to do more than that. So I've tried to make an effort about the project, a conscious effort about deciding what I do and what I don't do.
And also, you're well-trained. I read in your bio, you know, you've actually studied acting. It's not like you just woke up and said, I'm going to be an actress, and then, you know, got in something. You know, you've actually, like, studied your craft. You've making good choices and good decisions. And even the horror movies that you've done are with, like, At Granny's House. I think that's considered a horror movie, isn't it?
Yeah, I think it's like a psychological thriller. Yeah. Kind of falls in that vein.
But you're, you know, working with really cool people. I know. I looked at your thing because a lot of the people that you've done stuff with, I either know or we've had them on the show. You did a movie called After School Special, which I thought looks cute. I didn't get great reviews, but it's got a great cast, and I'm gonna watch it as soon as I can find out where to watch it. But like we know Jason London. I know Eric Roberts, Ron Jeremy. Like you have like cool people that you've been in.
I interviewed Jason London. He and his at that time fiance, and he was just the sweetest, nicest. Best one of my best interviews. He's a great guy. What do you think?
Same thing. That's always like such a great experience where you go when you see people that have like a really good established career, and then they're also really nice. It's like, oh yay, they're still humble.
He was a sweetheart. I remember his interview out of the thousands I do.
I think this one is a horror movie, Feast of Fear, with Clint Howard, but Robert Davi. We had Robert Davi on the show.
He's another great guy.
He's another, like, you know, super great talent who's had a great diverse career, and he's a singer. He sings Frank Sinatra and stuff.
Yeah.
He's, like, really, really good. He has a Davi Sings Sinatra album, and we had a blast with him.
It was a lot of fun.
Did he sing for you guys?
We played music off his album because he sent us this album.
Okay.
And then you did Last Call at Murray's with John Savage, which I'm a huge John Savage fan, and Michael Gross, who's the dad on Family Ties, who we like from all those Tremors movies.
Yeah! It was funny. You know? Right after we finished that movie, the following year was like the 25th anniversary of Tremors. And I was like, wow! He's had a 25-year career off of that.
Yes.
You
There's
know,
like six of five or six of them. We've seen all of them.
He went to South Africa to film the sixth one. I was like, whoa, that's crazy. Yeah, but he was such a joy. Same thing. He was super nice and super professional. And John Savage was very invested. Like, he was very present. He wasn't on his phone the whole time. He was on the set. He was engaged with everyone and trying to figure out how to make the scenes as best as possible.
I love that.
Yeah.
Tremors I really found to be very interesting, and I'm not a lover of those films, but I've seen every Tremor. Even the bad ones that, you know, were stupid. But I enjoyed them. I thought it was a very good idea of everybody has a fear of the earth and what comes out of the earth. Mm-hmm.
I have to say, though, because I'm a horror movie fanatic, like I actually
he pronounces horror. He pronounces
it's horror.
Horror.
How do you say horror?
Horror.
Well, the horror movies.
Yes, like horror movies.
It's just interesting, the horror versus horror.
Yes, horror.
Yeah, well, that's what it sounds like when Jimmy says it. He says he loves horror movies. Well, not horror movies. We say horror from New York. But in New York, we say horror.
No,
it's a horror film.
But I was a celebrity clothing designer for many years, and the way I got into like starting to get celebrity guests was I used to take clothes to the different conventions and introduce myself to the celebrities and give them free clothes so I could take pictures with them wearing my clothes and then ask them to come on. When we started out, we were just a radio show, and that's how, you know, Clive Barker and Malcolm McDowell, and I met like all these like great, you know, cool people to get it going. So I'm like a horror movie like addict. I used to host a horror movie review show on YouTube that got like 50,000 hits a week.
Wow.
I'm a big fan of A horror movies, B horror movies, and also the ones that, you know, like we were in one that's just so pathetic you don't even want to like see it. It was so bad. We're not going to talk about it. So like I love the genre.
You know,
let me finish my thought. I love the genre, and I would watch it all the time. And like, I like to get cast in them just because it's fun because I can't really act. But I think that as a person who takes it as a serious profession like you, I think it's great to do them. But I also just really love the fact that you're doing so many different things. And you did a movie called Sex and the Single Alien. And like, what's it about? Because he loves alien shit. Mm-hmm.
Alien movies are my thing.
It was actually a remake. The director decided to remake it. He had made it in like the 80s, and he was this wonderful German man with this big German accent. But he decided to remake it, and it's basically about my husband in this movie gets abducted by aliens, and he will no longer have sex with me because he wants to have sex with the aliens.
Oh, that sucks for you.
I know. But somehow the aliens teach him. He grows, if you will, and they teach him some lesson, and he comes down and he's a much better husband, and there's more lovemaking.
Oh, I love it.
Especially if they taught him how to grow.
In more ways than one.
Absolutely.
I don't think I've ever seen that film, but I've seen something close to it.
I love it.
With what's his name? That nice guy that died of pancreatic cancer. What was his name? The wonderful from... I'm so bad with names, and he's famous as all hell. The young fella. He died too young. Good actor.
What was he
was
in?
An alien film?
The Batman guy.
No, it was about that he was an alien, and he came to this planet, and he fell in love with the woman who lived in a farm. And he would do all kinds of magic things for her. The guy that was in the
Gary Shandling?
No. I'll give you.
I like that movie though. That was a
you
good
know
movie.
What I'm talking about.
Yeah, we like that.
No, I'll give you his name in a minute. This is dreadful. He was in the Julie Newmar movie. You know, the drag queens, Julie Newmar.
Oh, RuPaul. Oh,
He played a drag queen. He played a woman, a blonde. You know who he is. My God, he died of pancreatic. Everybody in the chat room, come on, help me.
Somebody look it up, you guys in the chat room.
Help me. You know who he is.
Julie Newmar movie. I don't. You mean like Tu Wong Fu?
Tu Wong Fu. Julie Newmar did somebody or whatever.
Okay, hang on. I'll look it up.
And he was the lead. He's a fabulous actor. Anyway.
How to spell Tu Wong Fu. Anyway, go ahead.
Anyway,
going.
That movie, it was similar to that. But, you know, there's just so much you could do in writing and film. Everything overlaps something else.
Oh, Patrick Swayze he's Patrick talking about. Swayze.
Oh, God. That's easy.
How could I forget Patrick's name? One of the best actors of our time. And we lost him way
too soon.
I love
Roadhouse.
Way too soon. We lost him way too soon.
Okay, so you have a new movie. Well, actually, it's not a new movie. It must have just gotten distribution.
Yeah.
Okay, you have a movie that just got distribution. It's called... It is called At Granny's House, and it's by Les Mahoney. I guess he directed it. I don't know if he wrote it also, but Les Mahoney. But it also stars Bill Oberst, who's a huge star. And tell us a little bit about the film, and then, Chad, you get the trailer ready. We're going to play it for everybody.
Roger. Oh, yay. Okay. So, basically, my character comes in to be a caretaker for a woman, and she uses the home for other purposes. They start to bring in guests. As if kind of like an Airbnb, but like our own version of it. And different things happen based on my needs with these people.
Love it.
You're a vampire.
No, but she's a fucking evil bitch.
You're a hooker. Oh.
She's like, wait till you see the trailer. She's like an evil bitch.
So are you a hooker or what are you?
You'll have to watch the film.
Well, we're not going to see it. They never show us.
I know. I have a trailer link for it. You can watch. We can watch
it's
it later.
It's terrible. I hate this. We have to have them hook us up somehow so that we could see people's work.
Yeah.
So here's what we're going to do.
It's funny because you're in a movie called At Granny's House.
Yes.
And I was in a movie with Vincent Price years ago called At Mummy's House.
Oh, the really?
Mummy? At Mummy's House. It never made it. It never made it to the screen. It was a shame. It was a pretty good concept.
So how about this? Chad, you have the trailer ready?
We do.
All right. You introduced the trailer for us, Rachel. And and then just hang on while we play it for everybody.
You know who Vincent Price is?
Yes.
Oh, good. Yes.
She's
people.
An actress, though.
No,
real actresses,
people,
though, really know it. They know it. They know
I
stuff.
I just spoke to somebody the other day about Sophia Loren, and the guy was blank. Who? I said, you don't know who Sophia Loren is? And he was about 40. I figured, what jail were you in?
I know, but he wasn't in, like, great movies. She's more accomplished.
I mean, who hasn't heard of Sophia Loren?
Anyway, hold on. Go ahead, Rachel. Introduce the film.
Okay, everybody. Here's a teaser of At Granny's House.
There you
good.
Go. It was your agreement, not mine.
You need help? Now you've got it.
Listen, I really am here to make your life better. Really.
We want to take good care of you, right?
We'll make a great team.
Strange, maybe. Perfect, doubtful.
Yes, we are quite notorious here.
Two flowers.
Thank you, ma'am. Very tasty.
It's all about bringing people together.
Indeed.
You gotta be careful with these pills you're taking.
What about her?
What about her?
I'm not going anywhere.
You needed a knife.
You have to kill him. It's the only way out.
There you go. Looks good. There you go, Jimbo.
All right, everybody. So that's At Granny's House, starring Rachel Alig, who's with us on the line right now. I think the video, the movie looks terrific. The fact that Bill Oberst is in it is really cool. Where do people see it? Is it? It's out now on video on demand? Is it out yet or no? It's about to come out.
Yes, on iTunes and Amazon Prime.
There you go. And it's on. They're actually now, or it's getting ready to come out?
It is out.
It's out now, everybody. So Aquamanny's House is available now, you guys, on iTunes and Amazon Prime. We have Amazon Prime.
We couldn't see it, but I heard the music, and the music is very good. It's got a good, you know, sort of a train feeling, you know, moving quickly and
suspenseful.
Scary music. Yeah, developing music. So the soundtrack sounds good. I'm sure the film is just as good. We'll have to watch it.
Yes, it's on Amazon Prime. We can watch it.
Yay! We have that.
I watch everything that our guests, you know. I've learned a lot because I come from a different era. As you can see, all my friends behind me, Betty and Davis, Jane Russell, these were buddies of mine. So I came from that era of old Hollywood. Mm. And meeting Jimmy and being on this show, I had to learn all about new people. So I'm totally honest. If I don't know who they are, I say, I don't know who you are. I mean, I really don't know who they are. I know.
There's a lot now, too. And a lot of people are working actors that aren't necessarily names just because of the saturation of content. There's shows all over
streaming.
The place.
Now with streaming, like there's so many shows on everything. It's almost too much. It's great for actors. It gives them more opportunities, but it's almost too much.
Not really, because years ago a studio selected 30 or 40 people they groomed into stardom. Mm-hmm. And the publicity was great. You have to pay for publicity. You have to pay for hair. You have to pay for makeup. You pay for everything to be on screen. Years ago, the studio did that, and they made you a star. Today, everybody and their mother wants, you know, this I resent, and I don't give a shit out there if you don't like it or not. Don't think you're going to be an actor so your friends are going to be jealous or you're going to go to great parties. That's not what it's all about. You have to be an actor in here, not here. Your heart and soul has to want you to work, not for the money, not for the fame, but for the work. You want to read the script, become the character, and do a breathtaking job so that people will say you were wonderful, because that's the reward. The applause, the Jesus, you were great in that film from fellow actors. So get over yourselves if you got big tits and you're sexy and you think you're going to bang your way into Hollywood like Marilyn Monroe did and Jane Mansfield. Those days are gone, my dear. Rubber balloon boobs are a dime a dozen. Everybody and their mother's got them.
Also, I should tell you.
So a big chest will get you nowhere in Hollywood.
In the chat room, they're saying you have a lovely, bubbly personality. The movie looks creepy. The movie looks scary. They wanted to know if it was Bill Oberst. I don't know what the hell they were when I was like talking about how Bill Oberst is in it, but yes, it is. And that the movie looks really creepy. So I think you gotta like love it. I think it's gonna be a hit.
And you have one thing in your favor, my sweet. You look about 17. No, that's good. When you're 35. When you're 35 and you could play 22, that gives you a wide range of age.
Now, how did you come up with 35? You don't know how old she is.
Well, she's not 35, that's for sure. She's nowhere near it. She's a girl, yeah. She's maybe 25, 26, if she's even. But she looks...
I like the fact that you're not a blonde. We always seem to have a lot of blondes. Which is great. I think blonde is great, but I think that there's a lot blondes. There's so many blondes, and the fact that you're a brunette, a gorgeous brunette, is nice.
She's an actress. Tomorrow she
that's true. She could be blonde tomorrow.
In a blonde wig. I mean, all the actresses today, they change their wig colors because they want to be different characters. Look at the one I love, the beautiful black-haired girl. I love her best when she's a blonde. The beautiful young actress today, fabulous, big Jennifer.
Oh, Jennifer
Lawrence.
Jennifer Lawrence. I love her. What a brilliant. What a wonderful actress.
You know who he really likes, though? His favorite actress? What's her name? Michelle Dockery. Do you know who Michelle Dockery is? Michelle Dockery. She was Lady Mary in the Downton Abbey. And she has a TV show on TNT called Good Behavior, and it is like the best show ever, where she plays like a hooker, drug addict, thief, killer. Nothing like Mary, and it's so amazing.
And she's got not only an American accent, but a New York accent. How she did it, I'll never know. And back behind me is Betty Davis. I'm sure you know who Betty Davis is.
Yes.
And she was a good friend of mine. And I used to talk to her about, Betty, you know, were you upset about going on stage without makeup and looking old and ugly? She said, I'm an actress. She said, I'm not a glamour girl, like glamour puss, she said, like the rest of them. She said, you know, they don't last, those glamour pusses, because they're only good when they're young and beautiful. She said, me, when I'm an old bag, she said, I'll still be working. And sure enough, you know, she worked as an old bag. And that's another part of being an actor or an actress, is get rid of your vanity. Stop profiling to the camera. Stop worrying about your lighting. Is my makeup good? Am I looking good? Screw all that shit. Leave that up to the people who know what they're doing. Just go out there and do your job. Learn your lines, hit your marks, and do the best you can. That's my feelings about the work.
Don't you agree? Yeah, I prefer roles that are non-glamorous.
Yeah,
you get to throw it out the window. It's then that concern is so far diminished. I don't need to worry about do I look good or not, because I just my character wouldn't care. So I actually really I look for that. And if those characters come up in an audition or something, I don't wear any makeup. And that has been like a little secret of mine, where it requires more of an actor, where it's heavier material, or it's a little more intellectual, it's more dramatic, whatever, where it just requires more of an emotional range. I never wear makeup, and
that's
I
smart
them.
If you go for a ghostie or an audition, and the casting directors look at you, and you have a whole different other persona you're showing them, you may not be right for the part. But if you wear black and no makeup and you go, you're just a blank screen. And they look at you and they say, she's good for the part. All we have to do is put blonde hair on her and big lips and she's perfect. You know, don't do it for the casting director. That doesn't necessarily work, because your idea is not their idea of the character. So I find that if I go to a go see, I just go as an old man. What am I going to do? I can't be young.
He's 77.
You know. So I tell them, now, thank God, Hollywood has to hire men over 75 because of the union. They said
that it's over 65.
No, 75.
No, it's 65.
I read the whole article.
I know, but it's
Jimmy,
65.
The whole article, they said that we want to hire
seniors, 65.
No, but they said 75 in the article I read, that they were hiring more 75-year-old actors from the vintage years. Because they have to, because there's a lot of us still alive.
That's not why they get tax breaks for doing it.
No. Stop being a cynical prick.
That's why they do it, though.
No, they don't do it for that reason. They do it because we are the largest group of senior citizens in the history of the world. There are more seniors living today than any other time in history. And we go to the movies, not just the kids. Okay, so what they're doing is they're putting an old bag in a movie with a young superstar.
Yeah, like
and that brings in both audiences.
I love that one.
Finally got smart.
The Intern with Robert De Niro and Anne Hathaway.
Oh no! But what's the other one?
Millions of movies.
The Intern, and maybe it was The Internship or something.
Tons of movies are doing.
Oh well, they did Robert De Niro and Zac Efron too, as his grandfather or whatever.
Yeah,
that was a good
one.
I forgot, but that was a fun movie.
But yeah, exactly what you're saying. They've got this older star, like huge star, and then this younger star, and they get both generations, and they get both
absolutely.
The
other.
Now I want to talk about something really important. Burt Reynolds. You know Burt Reynolds, of course. Superstar, Burt Reynolds.
Yes, he is, yes.
You know, who's up there in years, and you know, he wears a full wig, and he's old, and he's wrinkled, and whatever. He's in a movie right now that he's going to win the Academy Award for. Best Actor. The movie's called
The Last Movie Star or something
like
that.
And it's about this group of people want to put an award together and give it to Burt Reynolds, who used to be a great movie actor.
It's not for Burt Reynolds. He plays a character.
Yeah.
Right.
But it's very true to life, though.
We saw it, and I must tell you, Burt Reynolds was – I never thought he could act, tell you the truth. He was just a sexy guy that was wise-ass. But his mean, you got to hear him. He spoke from his heart, his lines, when he was talking about who wants me and I'm old. And I'm like, he absolutely got it. Everyone out there, please go see Adam Rifkin's film.
Yes, that's second thing. Do you know who Adam Rifkin is?
The director, producer, Adam Rifkin. You should know him. He does one.
Yeah, you should know him. You'd like him. He's a cool guy.
He'd like you. He'd cast you in something.
He did that movie Detroit Rock City back in the day, which made
Yes, of course.
That's his film.
Adam is
a
fabulous.
He's got a bunch of really good films.
He's a fabulous producer. Anyway, go see The Last Movie Star. You should see it because you could learn from it. If ever one day, you know, you have to play that sort of a part. He didn't play it like Norma Desmond. Do you know what I mean? That Hollywood grandeur. He just played it sitting in a chair, slumped over with barely speaking. I mean,
So let's do our thing. This is a thing I like to do with actresses and actors. So let's say you have a bucket list, and any movie that's ever been out in the past, if you could have been the star of that movie, what movie would that be that you would like to have been in? And then who's your bucket list for actor and actress that you'd love to like work with in a movie that you haven't been able to work with so far?
Okay. The movie that I would want to be in, oh, that's really funny because we talked about it, Girl Interrupted.
Oh, okay.
There's two. There's two.
You're talking about a part that everybody kills for.
Yeah, that's like requires dramatic skills and emotional range, and that's why Angelina Jolie won an Oscar, because it was...
And what about Winona? Come on.
Winona, of course, yeah. Oh, so
Winona was brilliant.
Or my favorite movie, The Deer Hunter.
Really? Now, nobody's ever said that. Wow.
And yeah. I didn't care for that film.
I loved it.
No, I didn't see anything in it that appealed to me. No, not at all.
Okay.
Yeah, I loved it. That last shot, I always say, like, a movie, if I can't remember the end, you probably didn't finish your story somehow. Like, it didn't come full circle. The ending,
that's true.
Very
true. You know, like, you don't remember an end to a movie because it probably didn't finish in some way. Last shot in that movie, hilarious. They're singing. They all start singing God Bless America. And Meryl Streep starts it, and then the camera pulls out super, super, super slow. And I just remember weeping, and it was, like, so powerful. So that would be the other one.
Okay.
And then as far as people that I would like to work with, Joaquin Phoenix.
Oh, my gosh. We don't get too many of those either.
Who I knew.
He knew him really well.
Well. Cool. Walk was quite an actor. Is still quite an actor, and a great person. And as a human being, he's quiet, but he's very caring of the planet, of everything that disturbs our planet. Joaquin is very involved with.
Okay, so that's your male. Who's your female?
Female would be. It would be Meryl Streep.
God darn it. Everybody always says that. I don't like that one.
I know. But her body work is just like her body work.
Yeah, but her work is not really that sensational because – no, really it isn't. Because,
he doesn't like her.
I don't like the fact –
He doesn't like her politics.
That she's – no, I agree with her politics. I just don't like that she's in politics. Actors should keep their mouths shut because they lose a lot of fans. If you're a Republican, don't put the Dems down. Don't put the Dems – don't put the Repubs down. You just can't do it. You have – like on – nobody knows my political – status, and then they never will. You know, I'm a communist, and I vote for Russia and Redism. just kidding.
You gotta watch it.
No, just kidding, folks.
The White House will be here.
No.
Secret Service will be knocking on our door.
No. Meryl Streep does Meryl Streep, no matter what. She tries so hard to be in character, but that Meryl Streep personality just comes through because she's so powerful. You have to be a weak personality to change character. Betty Davis also had a problem with that, and she would tell me that. She said, I never wanted my co-stars to be strong men, because then if I was playing a demure woman, I would have to be strong like them, and my character as a demure woman wouldn't work. So if I'm a demure woman, I want a man who's sympathetic to my demurity. Is that a word, demurity?
I don't know. You just made it up.
We
make up all kinds of
stuff. Don't you love it? Demurity. Oh, my God. That's gorgeous. Anyway, I learned a lot from Bette, you know, listening to her. And she opened up to me because she knew I wasn't out just for Betty Davis, the star. I loved her as a crazy old lady with a dirty mouth. I mean, she and I together said more fucks in one luncheon than anybody ever said in a year. I mean, she just loved my Brooklyn dirty mouth, and I loved her Boston dirty mouth. Anyway, so there's a lot of things that she – I wish she would have done a book about how to act and how to portray a character and what to look for in your director and your co-star. Mm. I mean, because there's so much – if you work with Angelina Jolie, you're going to have a hard time. a very hard time because the camera's on her. People are going to wait for her. And you have, you know what I mean? When is she coming back on the screen? We love looking at her. So you have to understand that, and you have to say, okay, I'm not going to work with Angelina Jolie. I'll work with somebody else who's not quite as beautiful or important. And you have to do that. I know it sounds bitchy, but you don't want the camera on the other person all the time. Like W.C. Fields said, never play with animals or kids because you'll never get on camera. You know?
It's kind of true, though.
Kids and the animals.
What about TV shows? Do you have any certain TV shows that you are like, oh, my God, like, what do you watch on TV? Do you watch TV? First of all, I guess I should ask, do you watch TV?
I watch more streaming.
Okay, that's what I watch, too. I only stream everything.
I honestly don't even know a network show that I watch, which...
Did you see the network show now? I don't even remember the name, but the girl won the Emmy for it, where she's a comedian. It's like in the remember that one with the comedian lady? The girl who's the comedian who's married and her husband wants to be a comic, but then she becomes the comic and she says all kinds of really wild things.
Oh, she's another good actress on her
way
up.
Oh, I forgot.
What's her name?
Isn't that funny?
She's a newie.
It's like set in like the 50s or 60s,
yeah,
I think.
She's a newie.
She won the Academy the Emmy Award for Best Actress.
Oh, yes.
Now I forgot the name of it. Isn't that terrible? The Marvelous Mrs. Maple or something.
No,
yes, I know what you're talking about. I haven't seen that. That's on my list.
You have to see that. That's really good.
There's so much stuff out there.
The wonderful Mrs. Mitzner or Meisner or something like
that. Yeah, it's good. Yeah. You'll like it.
It's great.
My favorite of recent is Handmaid's Tale.
Okay, I haven't seen that. Is it good? Because I keep seeing the commercials.
It's so amazing. It's so amazing. It's so amazing. I read the book in high school, I believe, and it's still one of my top 5 favorite books. It
wins all kinds of awards.
Yes, it's exceptional. It's beautifully shot. The cinematography, the writing, the acting, it's super powerful and engaging, and the unfolding of events of how things happen, it's pretty great. And
okay.
I
have to see that.
For some reason, I'm dropping the lead actress. She was also in Mad Men.
Okay, I know who you mean. I'm so bad with names. It's terrible.
No, I don't know why, but she was just, it's breathtaking. It's breathtaking.
Who else is in there? Is the girl from
Hollywood
Michelle Dockery's show. Is in
Hollywood Inside, and I cannot say who I got it from, but I got it from someone who I know well, who was very close to Antonio Banderas. She's very close to him. And the word is that he's doing a brilliant job with Picasso.
Which just started last night. We missed it.
And we have to watch Picasso, everybody, because I hear Banderas is outrageous in it. Totally doing a number.
I love
it. And
that's
the buzz in Hollywood right now among all the Yentas. Yep.
I got to see that. We'll have to see it. I like it.
With Antonio Banderas?
Yes.
If he turns out to be a great actor, because he never was.
Mm.
He was okay. He was like a pretty boy. And I spoke with
him. They're saying he's a good actor, though.
Well, I'm talking to her. You know who I'm talking to.
Yeah, I know.
I can't say her name because she wouldn't like it. Maybe she would.
No.
Tippi Hedren, who gives a shit? But anyway, remember Tippi Hedren from The Birds?
Mm-hmm.
She's his mother-in-law.
Oh.
Yeah, he's married to Melanie.
Do you ever see How to Get Away with Murder?
Yes.
I love that show.
Yeah.
Like, I think you would be cool if you were, like, you could play the Lauren role. Like, if you played the brunette role. Like, I could totally see you doing, like, something like that. And what a stellar cast that show has got.
Such
a stellar cast.
She's got the kind of face that...
You actually kind of remind me of her, though, a little bit.
No, if you make her up, she could be anybody.
Absolutely.
I mean, she's got that sort of face. Her features are very, very perfectly, like the nose, the mouth, the eyes. So you could do anything with them. If a person has a prominent nose, there's just so much you could do with them. You know what I mean? There's just so much.
Somebody wrote in the chat room, Rachel Brosnahan. I don't know what that was for, though, so I don't know what that's for. But hold on, because we only have 2 minutes. So everybody listen.
Wait, just do me a favor. Sweep your hair up and watch how you change.
Oh, yeah.
Look at the face. Now look at that. Now she's look at that, beautiful. I love it up. You got an oval.
Yeah, like
you have an
too.
Oval face. Mm-hmm. Your hair looks beautiful up. I'd like to see it up and sloppy, all piecey, like a la putana, hanging all over. No, just stuck up and hanging. No,
I have to say that.
The pieces. Like a washerwoman, you know, sloppy, just like you got out of bed. Because look how gorgeous. Oh yeah, see, this is my thing. Oh my God, a different person. Look. Now I would cast her as something else.
I think though, like I
look at
you're
that.
Gonna be you guys are gonna be seeing Rachel Alig and everything. Rachel, she's gonna be doing horror, she's gonna be doing drama, she's gonna be doing comedy, she's gonna be doing everything. You have a beautiful infectious smile, you guys.
Yes.
What are you so if people do you have a Facebook fan page?
I do. It's just Rachel Alig, A-L-I-G, and I'm also on Instagram, same thing.
Rachel Alig, and also Twitter, you guys, which she doesn't do it much, but she's at Rachel Alig on. I just followed you on Twitter, I think.
Right before
thank you.
Alig.
Alig. Alig on Twitter is what I said.
Oh, Alig on Twitter. Well, take a breath between the Alig
and you guys,
and
you want to go see, you want to see her new film. It's called At Granny's House. It's streaming on iTunes. It's on iTunes. It's on Amazon Prime. She's got a lot of other great stuff, and she's going to have new stuff coming out all the time because she's got 21 upcoming projects listed
and
on IMDb.
Trust me. I've been in the business a long time. This girl's going to be seen a lot. So get used to her name.
Absolutely.
So listen, what is your last name? Wait, what are you? What kind of name is that? What's the ethnic background?
It's German. So really, the G should be like heavier.
Right.
Alig.
Alig.
Alig. All right. So we got to go, everybody. Rachel, we want to thank you. We want to thank October Coast for setting this interview up. We love you. We think you're fabulous. Congratulations on your career.
See you in Hollywood.
And anytime you have anything to promote, let us know. We'll bring you back.
See you in the movies, honey.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Hey, everybody in the chat room, thanks so much for tuning in and all around the world.
Girl. Yes, everybody.
Chad,
bye-bye.
You're a rock star. Thank you, everybody. See you guys next week. Woo! We got a great show. Have a good one, everybody. Enjoy your weekend. Bye. Can't test me, big up the girls inside the party. Let's get down to Crazy Jimmy. Big up myself and known as Alfie, the one and only, the Turkish MC. Always love the clothes of Jimmy. Bitch, I'm your one I wanna be. Jimmy Star, new celebrity. We'll take you out to Jimmy Stars. He'll dress you right, you'll feel like a star. We'll hook you up, now you look sexy. Your game is tight, gonna get laid tonight. You need you.